Have I ever told you the story of Weekend Gunnet? Oh, what a mighty tale that is. A tale of good and evil, of the righteous individual versus the evil collectivists. Weekend Gunnet came about when you took the based autism of 4chan's weapons board, K, and the cringe autism of Reddit's R-Gun subreddit, and mix them together to create something that is as both as stupid as it is amazing, as cringe as it is based. A long time ago, in an internet far, far away, there was a forum dedicated to discussion about guns. During the weekdays when normal people were killing time at work, they would make reasonable posts discussing the finer details of guns and their inner workings. On the weekend, the dredges of the gun community would shitpost blurry pictures of common guns, nearly always with one or more bare feet in the background. Along with these lesser quality posts, many of the weekend community would resort to autistic screeching in the comments as a way to give these types of people an outlet for their retardedness while attempting to declutter the main boards. Weekend Gunnet was created. What was Weekend Gunnet? It was beautiful, is what it was. I speak with no hyperbole that for a short period of time, Weekend Gunnet was the internet's greatest creation. Weekend Gunnet was a subreddit that posted extreme gun memes. And when I mean extreme, I mean extreme. Weekend Gunnet was what would happen if you took the First and Second Amendments, turned them up to 11, and drove them straight off a cliff. And it was beautiful. What was Weekend Gunnet about? Weekend Gunnet was about America. And I'm not talking about the America that sends hundreds of billions of dollars to a thinly disguised money laundering operation on the other side of the planet. Or the America that horrifically mutilates the bodies of young, impressionable children. I'm not talking about that America. No. I'm talking about the real America.
Whatever. Taxation is theft.
Oh! God damn it, motherfucker!
Yes! And then the communists came and fucked everything up.
And you just can't deny it. I'm better than you are.
Fire when ready.
Commence primary ignition.
He was just a rocket rover, and he surely shook with pride. He checked all his equipment and made sure his pack was tied. He had to sit and listen to those awful engines roar.
You ain't gonna jump no more. Gory, gory, what a hell of a way to die. Gory, gory, what a hell of a way to die. Gory, gory, what a hell of a way to die. He ain't gonna jump no more.
So why was Weekend Gunnet shut down? Well, it wasn't strictly speaking shut down. It was made private. But why? Why did the communists that are Reddit admins do that? Well, because of something called Fed posting. What is Fed posting, you ask? Fed posting is when you post memes about killing federal law enforcement officers.
Thank you.
Does Weekend Gunnit live on? Some say it does. In the form of Best Gunnit Weekend on Reddit or the website weekendgunnit.win, both of which I believe are controlled by US government agents. Weekend Gunnit is over. It exists now only in memories. But despite it being over, like Gamergate, no matter how hard the communists try, no matter what they ever say or don't say, think or don't think, do or don't do, the communists can't stop the fact that Weekend Gunnit, if only for a short period of time, happened, and that it proved something. It proved to some people, some very few people, that others like them existed, that there were people out there like them, and no matter how hard the communists tried, that couldn't be undone. Weekend Gunnit was like a brief, freedom-loving, libertarian, anti-statist, anti-fascist, anti-communist, anti-authoritarian, pro-American, true American, gun-loving flare. Shot up in the sky in the middle of a deep, black communist night. And for a short period of time, some men, for the first, last, and only time in their entire lives, knew, once and for all, they weren't alone.